Welcome to my channel. My name is Tech Dad. Which VR headset to buy in 2022 among the mainstream products? I will try to answer this question simply in this video. Well, no, because that's a bad question. The real question is, what type of player are you or would you like to be? That's the right question, because the three headsets discussed next are all good but aim at different players. We are, of course, talking about the Oculus Now Meta Quest 2, the HP Reverb G2, and the Valve Index. There are other options on the market like Pimax or Vive that may satisfy some gamers, but I will limit myself to the three popular choices available in 2022 in this video. The first type of player, the console player. VR on PC requires a very powerful computer with often a very expensive video card. Fortunately, it is possible to access virtual reality thanks to the Quest 2. Think Xbox, PlayStation, or Nintendo Wear. The Quest is a completely standalone console. Of course, it can't play some games only available on PC, but they are increasingly rare. PC VR is not dying, but it is becoming more niche than ever. The good news is that the Quest 2 can also work with a PC if you are able to buy one in the future, so you are not stuck with the Quest 2 forever. And it's a great headset for that too. The Quest 2 can even work wirelessly with a PC. You get it all with the lowest priced VR headset on the market. How is it even possible? Well, Facebook, or now Meta. This is the only real big disadvantage of the Quest 2 for some players. The product is not the Quest, it's not VR, it's you. The second type of player I want to talk today is the simulation addict. You want an headset for simulation on wheels or in the air? The HP Reverb G2 is for you, provided you have a high-end GPU like a RTX 3080, for example. The Reverb G2 has the highest resolution between the three choices, and it's not too expensive when there is some specials, like past Black Friday or Boxing Day. The main problems with the Reverb G2 are its controllers and their tracking. Like, it's not like really bad, but it's not great. It's not as good as the Quest 2, and certainly not as good as the Index. But for simulation games, we don't use them. The headset will still be functional for other types of games, but the experience is superior on the Index or the Quest 2, like I said. For simulation games, the Index can be an interesting solution if you don't have a state-of-the-art GPU, especially if you can save a lot of money by not buying the Index controllers. The resolution is not as good as the other options, but the viewing angle is the best, so the FOV, you have a better vision on the Index. Third type of player is the hardcore PC VR gamer, like the real hardcore. The Index by Valve is a great choice for the hardcore gamer who will put hundreds and hundreds of hours into certain PC VR games like VR Chat, for example, or some competitive shooters like the pro player playing Onward every day, every hour. The Index is for you. Money should not be an issue, because it is impossible to justify buying an Index with reason in 2022. The price was high 2 years ago when the product was new. Now the price is just too high considering the resolution of the screens, and the product is never on discount, even if it's getting old. But the Index offers the best tracking on the market, which can make the difference for some players. In addition to having a refresh rate of up to 144Hz. You buy an Index with your arc and not with your reason. But maybe also the fact of not encouraging Mark justifies for you this expense, and I must admit that it can be a good reason. The fourth type of player is the generalist. If you like all kinds of experience like me, the Quest 2 is for you. Despite its low price, it is the most complete device and the only one allowing you to play all the games on the market. whether directly on the Quest 2 or on PC. All games are easily accessible and compatible with the Quest 2.
A few moments later.
It does not necessarily excel in any category, but it is good in all categories. A jack of all trades, a master of none. There are of course some disadvantages on PC because the image must be compressed to transit by a USB cable or by the Wi-Fi, which requires additional resources and makes the image softer than a dedicated PC VR headset. But if you have a good PC, the Quest can achieve really good visuals with the proper settings, but you need a very good PC. Also, playing without wires is a must for me. But to go with the Quest 2, as I said before, you must agree to be spied on by the all-powerful Master Mark. The final type of player for today is the Thrifty. I hope it's good in English, I'm not sure. I'm calling it the Thrifty, or in French, l'économe. Your budget is limited, or you want to spend little money because you don't know if you will like virtual reality, or any other reason. I mean, it's not important, you just don't want to spend too much money on a VR headset. The Quest 2 is the best here and pretty much the only choice. And like I said earlier, it is a very good headset. Otherwise, buying an Oculus Rift S or Samsung Odyssey Plus on the used market can also be a good choice for PC virtual reality if the price is very good. I have multiple videos on my channel on these older headsets if you want to look at them. So I hope you have enjoyed my 2022 guide in a simplified and easy to understand format. Please consider liking the video and subscribing to this channel. I really, really need your help. Thank you all. Bye. It was TechDad. Merci à tous.